Welcome again. In the previous video, we saw non-string based non-overlapping as well as string based non-overlapping operation. This is what we saw. We have transferred a bulk of data from one location to another location manually. We have copied data into accumulator, data pointed by source index into accumulator, and from accumulator we have copied data to a location pointed by destination index register. We have taken a counter. The value of counter is equal to the number of data members we want to transfer. We decrement it every time when we transfer a data from source to destination. We check whether it has reached zero. If it has not reached zero, what we do is we decrement source, we decrement destination, okay, and we again repeat the same process of copying data from source to destination. So we have done this manually. And when it comes to string based operation, we saw that we are using string operations. Similarly, exactly same procedure we are going to use for overlapping operations. So we are going to see two aspects again, that is string based overlapping and non-string based overlapping operations. Procedure is same, but the way we are doing it is different. Let's see how it is done. First, let us see what is overlapping operation. So, consider a source, again the same thing what we did last time. So, consider a data like this, and consider a destination and let's have a data something like this. So there is an array X having data 1, 2, 3, 4. There is an array Y having data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we can see array X with data 1, 2, 3, 4. We can see array Y with data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Remember, we are studying non-string based overlapping operations. So we'll point source index again. We'll point destination index again. What we'll do is we'll copy the data from source index pointer into A register, and from here we are going to copy into destination. So 6 will go and 4 will come. We have already loaded the data, the counter with 6. So CL is equal to 5. So once we have copied this, it is going to be 4. We decrement SI, we decrement DI. So second instance, 3 is copied. Again we decrement. Again we copy. Again we decrement. Again we copy. Okay. So what happens? Sorry, we will take here counter as good as source, that is 3. So 3, 2, 1 and 0, it becomes 0. It becomes 0. Right? So what is the operation will stop? So what is the final result? Final result is 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 1. Right? This is what we find in the destination. In the Y. So what we see? 6 is overwritten by 4, 5 is overwritten by 3, 4 is overwritten by 2, 3 is overwritten by 1. Thus, we can see the data is overlapping. Data is getting overwritten on the existing data. And we have done this operation in such a way that, okay, we have copied source to destination by overwriting the data which is already existing in the destination. And we have done this manually. We have pointed source index to source, we have pointed destination index to destination. We have loaded counter with the value that is there in the source. We have loaded it with 3. We have copied The data are pointed by source index into accumulator and from accumulator into destination index. We have decremented CL. We have checked whether it is 0. If it is not 0, we have decremented SI, decremented DI. And again, we have repeated the same task, copying the content pointed by source index into AX and from AX into destination index. Now, people will ask me, sir, why don't you copy from source index into direct destination index? Remember, data directly, remember, there is a device 1. And there is a device 2. Data from device 1 to device 2 cannot go directly. There has to be some memory in between. What is the reason? The reason is the operational speed of two devices can never be equal any time in life. No two devices are ideal. No two devices will have same operational speed. Considering this scenario, it is always advisable that you will have some memory. So what is done? This is Mr. X, this is Mr. Y. This Mr. X acts with a speed of 10 items per second. This Mr. Y works with a speed of 8 items per second. So if this person starts giving data directly to D2, two items will be in loss. So instead of that, what is done? A bucket is kept, which is of the size maybe 30. And Y person tells X person that whatever data you want to give, you dump it in this bucket. I'll pick up as per my speed. So this is how D1 is not worried, that is Mr. X is not worried. He'll simply dump the data in the bucket. And Y is not worried because he can pick up the data from this bucket as and when he wants with a speed that he is comfortable with. So what is this bucket? This bucket is a buffer. And that is why this intermediate memory is what is accumulator that we are using. Right? So this is about non-string-based overlapping. How about string-based overlapping? Same thing repeated again what we did in the last experiment. Again we are using the same scenario. Again same scenario. Okay? So data is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? And here data is, we will take extra locations. Okay, here data is maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and maybe 6. Again source index pointed, again destination index pointed. Okay, and now in this case, repeat move SB or word move SW, whatever it is. We'll have counter loaded with 4, 3. And once we hand it over to this, okay, what will happen? It will automatically copy the data from source to destination. Okay. Check decrement CL, check whether it is not 0. Decrement SI, decrement DI. Again copy the data from source to destination. Again copy the data from source to destination. Again copy the data from source to destination. CL reaches 0, stop. And then display this data. And what is displayed is 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 1. Again, we can see the older data is overlapped by new data, and that is why it is overlapping operations. And since we have used string in order to do this overlapping operation, that is string based overlapping operation. That's it. That is all about two experiments that we are going to conduct in our practical session, that is experiment number 2 and experiment number 3. And experiment number 2 is non-overlapping operation without string, non-overlapping operation with string, and experiment number 3 is overlapping operation without string and overlapping operation with string. So with these two experiments, we learn and understand importance of string-based operation. Remember, very important thing, memory will decrement if D bit is set. Memory will increment if D bit is reset. What is D bit? Is a direction flag. Direction flag. The moment you set direction flag, SI and DI pointer will move in reverse direction. If we reset a direction flag, SI and DI will move in bottom up incremental direction. So that is the magic of string based operation. That is all. Thank you.